Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in the Cube, and in this video, I'm going to show you a new way to share a personal bookmark. It's pretty interesting. Let's do it. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. So I did a video a while back talking about how do we actually share a bookmark, so a personal bookmark. And in that video, I talked about the fact that if you create that personal bookmark, just copying the URL, sending it to the user doesn't, enough all this talking. You know, we like to do it here on Guy in a Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to my machine. All right, so if we look at this report and I just select something, I wanna spotlight it, and then I wanna make a personal bookmark, and bookmark one is fine. We'll save that, and if I click on that bookmark, what you'll notice here in the URL, open up my trusty Notepad app, and we'll actually see a URL and the bookmark in that URL. And this is what I showed in the other video. If I go over to John Doe and I put it in his browser, it'll come up and say, that bookmark's not available because it's not in the context of John. And what I showed in that video is the fact that you can use the chat in Teams to generate the URL that includes the bookmark, and that is valid for the end user that receives that URL. So it's effectively you're giving that permission as part of the chat in Teams capability. But there was an update inside of Power BI that actually lets you do this in a more targeted way. So let me go back in my personal bookmark. And then what I want to do here is I can actually use the share dialog. If you're familiar with SharePoint or OneDrive, this should be familiar to you. And so we can choose specific people with existing access, or people in your organization. And you can actually say whether they can reshare the report or they can build content as part of that. We'll apply. And so in this part, I'm fine. Anyone in my organization, if they get this, the key here is to check this include my changes. That's the big thing. So it's taking into account, what did you change as part of this? So you don't even need a bookmark per se. Copy the link. We'll go back to Notepad, and we can see here it's a different link, app.powerbi.com/link. And it also does have a bookmark with as part of that. Let's go back to John Doe, paste that link in, and bam, it shows the way that I set up the report and gives it to John Doe in the way that I wanted. That's bananas. Oh my gosh. That is so much cleaner than doing the chat in Teams just to get this capability. There is absolute value in chat in Teams. I absolutely recommend, if you're using Teams in your organization, you should be taking advantage of those features for collaboration. But if you just want to get a link out to someone, maybe you want to include it in an email, this is a nicer way to go about doing it. You can be more targeted with what you want to allow with that link. One other caveat here though, let's go back into what I showed in the previous video. If I go into apps, go into VentureWorks. One thing you'll see here though is when I'm in an app and I want to do the same thing, I want to get this and do spotlight, there's no share capability inside of an app. And so the only option you have is this chat in Teams. I don't know why share's not there within the context of the app. It probably has to do with how app permissions work. And so that kind of breaks that concept in terms of governance and whatnot. But just know that inside of an app, there is no share button. So you don't get that dialogue. You still have to do chat in Teams if you're consuming the report through an app. It still works and it's still viable, so you can share that link out. But if you're just going against a report in a workspace, you absolutely have a better option here. All right, I want to hand this over to you. What do you think? Is this something that you actually do? Do you include those links? How do you share your personal bookmarks? Were you using the chat in Teams before? Are you using the share dialog now directly from Workspace? Let me know in the comments below. I want to hear it. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button. Smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.